Hello, my artist friends, and welcome back to my channel. So first, I'd like to wish you all a great year, a happy new year. I got a full week with my family and friends, and it was really great. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how I painted this painting here. It was like an old painting that I've made before, but I didn't have the chance to film any footage of this painting, so I've decided to redo this one on a little piece of paper. And it was also for a secret project that I have this month. Also, I've ordered some new paint, and I need to make a video about this paint because this will be the first time I try the water-based oil paint. It is water-soluble oil paint, and I can't wait to try those type of paint. It is really a new thing for me, and yeah, I don't really know how it can work and how it is drying and how, yeah, the difference between acrylic and oil paint. So I'm going to try this paint and make a video for you. Okay, now let's paint. So as I told you, this one is on paper. I've put some tape on my table and applied some gesso onto a paper, a thick paper. So here I've already made two parts, the beige part and the blue part. I've already applied one coat, but since it is a little bit too transparent, I'm going to apply a second coat to have a strong color and a strong base with the full opacity of color. So here I'm using, as always, the greenish blue and some black. And for the bottom part, I'm using a buff titanium color. These ones are acrylic color. You don't need to have any specific brands. I use regular acrylic paint. I try to go back and forth with my brushes, so I don't have many brush strokes showing when it will be dry. So here I'm preparing my palette. I'm using the same color here plus some white, and I will be using also some rose sienna and dark brown, like burnt umber. I like to spray my palette so my paint it is more fluid and I can really work with it easily. I'm just referring to an older design that I've made that I showed you earlier in the video, and I like to think this piece as a large piece of marble or onyx rock marble. And I like the fact that it is two part, like blue and beige with the gold in the middle. Yeah, I think that those color goes really well together. And yeah. So as I told you, I really can't wait to try the oil paint base, water-based paint, because I think it will be a great paint to smudge and create beautiful blends with it without drying too fast, like the acrylic paint here. And this paint also has great pigments, more quality pigments than this one, so I can't wait to see the colors. So here you see I'm highlighting the painting with some white and water. I like to give it a little wash like this of color, just to bring some transparency, and it will look more like a stone and, yeah, more abstract. Here you can see by just adding water to the blue, I can really have a nice transparent look to the painting. But here that's not the point, because I'm going to spray some water onto this part, and it will create some beautiful cells and a nice organic blend. And maybe I will try to do a large painting only with this technique, because I really like how this corner turned out. Now I'm going to work on the darker area just by mixing some black and dark brown with my beige color. I'm going to work on different details, but try to make some shading. It will just create a more 3D effect. And yeah, here you can see that I'm using my lovely Posca pens with a dry brush just to blend my Posca easily. And I really like to use those pens, and I'm currently run out of Poscas. I really need to buy some more. Here I'm just glazing some rose sienna onto my blue and beige color, and you can really see how it brings the painting to life. Now that my painting is dry, I can focus on the base layer of my gold, and today I'm going to use the golden medium. It is a lacquer medium that you can work on layer. It really dries like 3D, so that's why I'm applying it with a little palette knife. And yeah, I want it to be a little bit messy, so when I put my gold on top, it will create some nice design. You will see what I'm talking about later. And it really dries transparent, so you can use this one as a varnish or a glue, or you can put some pigment in it, you can put some texture sand. Yeah, you can really play with those mediums. So here I'm applying the last details, and I'm going to highlight and create some last cracks and small details in my painting. Here I'm also adding a little shade under my 3D medium, just so my gold really pops out of the painting. And also I'm adding a little bit more raw sienna / orangey tone to the painting. It really contrasts with the blue, and I really like those colors together. I'm taking here a little brush with some white to create some more cracks and details and highlights. Usually I'm using a small Posca pen, but I was out of this size of Posca, so that's why I'm using here a little brush. This is the old technique of brush, but you can also use the Posca pen. So now that everything is dry and set, I'm going to apply my gold leaf glue. This one is from PBO. This is the only one that I use on all of the videos. And I'm going to try to be not as precise as usual. I'm going to be a little bit messy, just so my gold is not too... it don't have any straight edges or sharp edges. I want it to be a little bit messy, and I'm trying to only apply the gilding paste onto the medium, the 3D medium that I've applied, so my gold will only stick on that. So now that my gold leaf glue is dry, I can apply the gold onto the 3D part. And you will see after why I've used this medium. It is much shinier, and it creates a beautiful texture under my gold. After that, I'm going to sign my work and apply two coats of varnish, and here is the full result. You can really see here the 3D under the gold, and it creates a really nice texture. Also, the paper is really smooth, so that's why I have a beautiful sheen on it. And yeah, a huge thank you to all of my Patreon here. And if you want to subscribe to my Patreon and watch the full video tutorial on this painting and many others, you can now subscribe to my Patreon page. I've put the link down in the description. Thank you for watching my video. I wish you all a great day and see you. Bye. Bye, guys.